Hey, what's going on, party people? Just popping in here real quick. I'm gonna try to make this real brief. I want to thank everyone who tuned in and took the time to watch the video, Be a Man. Thank you to everyone who watched it on Instagram, those who chimed in on Instagram, those who commented here on YouTube. There's some comments that I didn't go into depth of response because I said I'm just gonna respond in a video because, and it will address anything that comes after that, so I don't have to repeat myself. There may be people that just started watching me. This doesn't just go for me, it goes for anyone in their channel. Their platform is your platform for you to share whatever it is you're gonna share. On my platform, I share bits and pieces of my life, my experience. When people, and not this here on YouTube, whatever in life, if someone is sharing their experience, something they're going through, don't diminish what they're saying. Don't make light of what they're saying. Don't make excuses for listen, don't do it, because it's their experience, it's their feelings. Don't do it. You can share what you want to share, but don't make light of what the person is sharing with you, because that is their experience. Okay, let's move on. So let's go to the first. And again, this is no, again, oh come on, I'm responding to comments as I
go. So the first comment I want to go through, okay. And I'll just take it bit by bit. Some people are where are we?
Some people are who they are, and they are where they are in life. And although it may be frustrating or irritating, we must learn to accept that these people cannot suddenly be any different than who they are because we entered the room. Let's stop there. That's nice, but no. Yeah, you can't change who people are, but you also don't have to accept disrespect. So, let's just even just, you're gonna make this even more thing. Say I was transgender, or I was transitioning. So I walk into a room, and okay, haven't fully gone through, I have triple D's. Yes, we're gonna be, let's get into this right now. So I walk into the room, and if I say to them to address me as, you know, I walk in there, and people know me as Sam or whatever, and they don't know everything I'm going through, and my name, I'm changing it to Samuel, and they told me Samantha, I said, no, you know, I don't have to go through a whole explanation, but it could have went through personnel, whatever. They know I'm transitioning. I'm saying, call me Samuel. So you're saying, because everyone is used to seeing me, Samantha, oh, this busty woman, I'm supposed to accept that because, oh, no, this is who I am. That's who I see you as. And I'm going to call you what I want to call you. No, no. Again, you don't, we ain't looking to, I'm not looking to change who you are, your thought process, but as for you and I in this dialogue, whoever I'm talking to, you're going to respect my pronouns. You're going to respect what I'm saying, who I am. I'm sorry, that... No. No. And in this climate we're in, that's like totally disrespectful to people who are in their pronouns. Because, oh, I... They shouldn't be different because I entered a room. So, just let things go because... Oh, they who they are. The devil is a liar. Not doing it. But anyway, yeah. I've learned that what's logical to me may not be logical to someone else. And with that understanding, I've been able to be more tolerant of people who aren't like me. Yeah, you could be tolerant. But again, there is a time and place where you have to put people in their place. Across the board, customer service. Hello, how can I help you? How can I help you? Can I help you? How can I help you? You do not have to assign a gender to greeting people. Okay. You don't have to. You don't have to. And so bringing it back to what, you know, the video was about. No. She, all the receptionist could have said was, how may I help you? Or, do you have an appointment today? Or, what's your name? Do you have an appointment today? That has nothing to do with, oh, someone where they are in life, blah, blah, blah. It's your job to know how to greet people, period. And all the instances that I've had, they're having to do with service people. Yes. So this is my experience. So don't tell me about, oh, like turn the other cheek and, oh, they don't mean nothing. Shut up with it. And I'm not trying to, look, I'm very passionate about this because it's my experience. It's what I go through. What I constantly go through. And no, it is not right. I could give you an example. Several examples. Being in a restaurant. I can't hide. And again, I don't look like a dude. A server will come to me, and it's mostly men that have done that. Oh, sir, yeah, what can I guess? Like, you can't miss my chest. And someone said in the comment, oh, you know, some men have boobs. Look, stop with the fucking excuses, man. And let me even go with that. Okay, say some men have boobs. May I take your order, please? What are you having on the menu? These are things that businesses need to teach their front end. So, I hear what you're saying, but no. no. Ba-da-da-ba-ba, where are we? When you can broaden your perspective, then it's easier to not take the way people are so, well, personally. Again, you are not in my shoes. You haven't been in my experience. And going back to what you were saying, the fact that you haven't been in my shoes, you should be more respectful of when I'm saying, if I'm correcting you in something having to do with me, then that's how you address me. It's an excuse. I'm sorry. Just because you haven't had my experience. No, you don't have to understand, but you're going to respect it. That's it. Where are we? I'm sure the person wasn't intentionally trying to insult you or be disrespectful. I'm glad you know what their intentions were. But baby girl, I've been through this many times. And it continues to happen. One time I was driving, going into a store. The store is, I have to make that turn in to my right. All right? I'm in the outside lane. There's a double yellow lane. The outside lane. Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Now I need to go into the store on the right. I'm clear to turn. To go into the other lane, to turn to go where I'm going. There, I'm clear. So I indicate to go over. This car speeds up. Now you see me in the, you mad space, speeds up. I turn into the lot to go by my business, to go buy whatever the hell I'm buying. Park my car. Tell me why that car followed me into the lot. Guess what? A dude jumps out the car. Now, I'm like, what the fuck? I come out my car again. I'm going to go buy my business, buy my work, buy whatever. The man is carrying, oh, why you cut me off? When he saw me, you know what this man said? Oh, I'm going to beat you like the man you want to be, the man you trying to be. Oh, so I'm supposed to take that as unintentional? Listen, people know what they're doing. And people like me that have been through this, we know. So again, do not make light of people's situation when they're telling you their experience. This is all cute, but it's not, in my world, it's not realistic. And it's like, oh God, it's like, wow, really? And then no. Oh my God. Hearing your view most certainly helps me to understand why you feel the way you do. But if we also see, where I do, now you said but, so right now we're about to negate what you just said. But if we also look at the perspective of the other person who hasn't walked in your shoes, who doesn't know your life, who may not have had the opportunity to learn how to be open-minded enough to approach you in the way you prefer, then it's easily to understand that she says she is just being who they are and cannot be anything else. You can let it go because it's superfluous and grand. Again, that's good for you because you do not experience it. So you cannot tell me to let it go. Again, when people tell you their experience, don't make light of their situations and what they feel and what they're going through. Stop it, people. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. You know, I wish it was a fact that you could walk in my shoes and you'd be like, oh, shit. Oh, shit. So stop. Stop. And the thing is, I'm not the only one that goes through this because people have been chiming and people that don't, they understand and they've been through it and they know what I'm saying. I'm not talking fuckery. Oh, because it's superfluous in the grant. No. Because this is the problem. So if people have this thought process, people will think it's okay to just call you whatever the thing they call you because how you look. No, you're not doing, no. It's not, no. other people, they won't let it go, that's fine. But again, I'm sharing my experience and how I feel about it and how, no, I'm not going to let it slide when it happens. Okay, I'm glad you got it off your chest because that's important to, okay, blah, blah, blah. But it also breeds understanding and tolerance if you can step back and look at it objectively. No, because again, I know when people make an honest mistake and when they're doing it intentionally. I know this. I could give you so many examples. Listen. Listen. Oh my, let me jump in. Boom. I was dating someone years ago. We went out. They were taking me out. It's very remember because I don't do the train. So we took me on the train. We was going on the train. We was in the elevator. You know, we stand by ourselves, we talking and stuff. So we in the elevator. Whoever been to New York been in them elevators, in the subway elevators, yeah. So we standing here, more to the back, and the gentleman up there was to my left. And you could hear him above on his voice. You with that? You could have a real man. Now, mind you, so I should just let that go, right? But you know something I did, because you know something? Even though I know he's being a fucktard, I don't want to die because of who I am. Now, should I take it like, oh, he's never been in my shoes before? Fuck that. He knows that I am a masculine-centered woman. He's mad that I'm with a woman. That's the whole thing. And this is what I'm going back to say, back to the video. What the fuck is wrong with you? What the fuck is wrong with you? If the woman's with me, obviously she's a lesbian or bisexual. So what is your problem? Again, men have a problem with women that look like me. So no. While you want to say turn the other cheek, you cannot turn the other cheek because it's all up in our faces. The disrespect is right in our faces. So please, stop. Oh, stop it. Let's go to the next one. I was trying to make this brief. We're 12. We're going to do this. And previously I touched on this comment. I didn't go into depth about it. But the comment initially was, with the coming of trans and non-binary, it is truly hard to tell. She may have thought you were trans and wanted to be respectful or glance at your masculine appearance because, like you said, you were half covered. So because you can see from my shoulders up, I look masculine. No, I do not. No, I do not. Okay. Please, let's give grace and always give people the benefit of the doubt of coming from a good place. No, I will not. Like I said before, I know when it's an actual mistake and when it's being done deliberately. So no, in those instances, I will not give it grace. Okay. Now, if you confirm they are not, that's another thing. We already covered that. And this sentence just sums up everything. So for it to go on, yeah, okay. But I like your suggestion of simply asking how are you. Don't ask how I am. We in a place of service. How can I help you? Yeah, that is more customer service train push or why. Exactly. That's what it is. And it starts from there. And with that customer training, it will boil down into the person's regular everyday life. Okay. As a non-binary butch lesbian, I get sir a lot, and that's before people look up because of my height and hair. And to me, that's dumb. And this is that's dumb. Because of, so now height? Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh, Lord. So I said, thank you for watching. I appreciate your perspective. I can name so many instances, so on, where am I? I can name so many instances, so no, I'm not giving grace. I've had people look at my breasts and still want to call me a man, so no. And trans isn't new, non-binary is, okay? They come back. I understand your frustration, but I look at it this way. That's good. You understand my frustration? Period. Now tell me about you. Okay. There are men with breasts. From weight, I ain't gonna try to pronounce this. I think it's Gino.
Gynecomastia, which is.
I was kind of close. Gynecomastia. Okay. Gynecomastia and pre-op trans without hearing voice. And in this PC world, if you saw someone like you as a person, not close to LGBTQ,
What are you going to hedge your bet on? Be real. I don't know who to... Hello? What's your name? Hello? What's your name? I'm not going to assume. I see men with man boobs. So do I call them a girl or a woman? Unless that's what I'm... Unless, you know, if I address them and, you know, we get into... That don't make a difference to me. Why I don't get what the hell I'm saying? all of this factors, again, don't make... How are you today? How can I help you? Can I help you find something? Do you have an appointment? Can I take your order, please? None of these things have to be assigned gender. So when you look at me and if you are confused, how can I help you? Or what's your name? People, stop it. Oh my God. What, be real. What? Go with sir and recognize. What? Go with sir and recognize a man who could be different in appearance or with a ma'am. Okay, it must be man again. I don't know. That's a, okay. Or with ma'am and risk 75% chance it's one of the three others and not a real. See, all of this shit is ridiculous. No. Again. From my experience, for me, these instances have happened in the service industry. Even today, I was having a discussion about this with the front end in H&R Block. I told him what happened. And how is that? She totally understand what the fuck I said. Okay, let's move on. All of this shit is excuses. And you're having fucking manners and being... nice to people, being respectable to people. I don't have to know who you are, what you went through, what you're going through to be respectful of who you are. I don't. That's dumb. That don't make any sense. I had to know who you are, where you from, what you've been through to be respect, show your respect. No, son. So God. So let's, because I'm gonna wind up this video, and here we go. Is this more here? Oh God, these long ass girls. And if you're, where am I? And if you're wrong, then the woman who knows she appears masculine may understand. Like I said, I've said it in other videos before. I can understand, but that doesn't mean that I'm gonna accept or make you believe it's acceptable to use terminologies in referring to me as a man. Knowing it, I've said it many times before in different videos and stuff. I can understand if someone may. So all it, but it doesn't mean that I'm not going to correct. Okay, it's too long. I'm not. Yeah, y'all could go and look at the comment. But let me wrap this up. By saying, look, once again, how I started this. When people tell you their experience, don't minimize their experience. Don't make excuses for those experiences that happened to them. Don't do it. You can share your perspective, but in sharing your perspective, don't make small of what that person has experienced and is experiencing. And that's it.